Hey, what's up everybody, and welcome back to Gal. Today I'm showing you three motion tracking techniques inside of After Effects. So motion tracking, what it enables you to do is track the motion of a shot and then apply that motion to any added elements in your scene. So if you want to attach text to a static object in your scene, you can do that. Or let's say you want to add an animated call out to a moving object in your scene, or you want to replace a screen in a moving shot. I will show you how to do that. And I've added a time code down in the description box below to these specific effects. So if you want to skip ahead to go to a particular effect, you can just click on that time code. And all of the assets that I'm using in this tutorial are from Envato Elements, which sponsored this video. So if you guys are interested in unlimited creative assets from stock video to motion graphics, lower thirds, music, sound effects, it has it all. You can get 70% off with my link in the description box below for your first month. So thank you Envato Elements for sponsoring, and now let's go ahead and jump on in. First up is tracking text to a static object. This can be used for opening credits or to introduce a new location. So in my composition, I have this stock video aerial shot over the Brooklyn Bridge, and I'm going to use the type tool to type out the word Brooklyn in all caps, and I'm going to use a font called Go Bold Extra Regular. And then I'm going to select the text and rescale it up so it's nice and big, and I'm going to place it so it looks like it's just resting on top of the side of the bridge on the left. But as we hit play, you will see that the word does not move with the camera movement. So what we need to do is track the motion of this video clip, and to do that, we're going to go up to Window, Tracker. Then select the video clip from the composition and be sure to move the playhead to the beginning of the comp. This is super important because tracking should start at the beginning of the clip. Then from the tracker panel, select track motion, and let's alter the zoom of this composition to zoom in so we can better move the point in place. So I'm just going to click on the inside smaller square of this tracker point and then move it over a point on the bridge, which includes both a light and a dark contrast. And here looks just about right. Next, we need to choose a target. So select edit target. And from here, select the Brooklyn text layer. This is going to be the target layer. Then hit play until it tracks all the way through the composition. Once it's done tracking, hit apply and be sure to apply it to both the X and the Y coordinates. So now that this is done, we can open up the text layer and you will see that all of the tracking info was transferred over as keyframes to the position of the text, but it's in the wrong location. So we need to adjust the position of the text. Since we cannot change these current position controls because of the tracking data, what we need to do is go up to effects and search for an effect called transform, which is located under distort, and just double click to apply it to the text layer. Now from effects controls, you can move these X and Y positions to move the text wherever you like without destroying the original tracking data. This is like an extra position effect that does not affect the original position controls, which is super cool. So once you got this set in the place that you want and you hit play, you will have your final result. Next is the attaching callouts to moving objects effect. This is a popular effect used in many commercial and advertising work, and it's really not that difficult to do. So here I have this aerial shot of this car driving by. So the animated callout I'm using for this effect is from Envato Elements, and it was designed by Aqua Vitae. Now, you don't have to use these animated callouts. You can create your own text in After Effects, but I really like these because they make it super easy to quickly create animated callouts in your film. So once you download it, you'll find an After Effects file for each type of animated callout. Simply drag the After Effects callout files that you want to use in your current video into your After Effects project panel. So for the first track point, I'm going to use Box Callout 03. So open up that folder and then open up the tracking comp folder. In here, let's drag this comp into the current composition that we have open. Here you can grab the end of this callout layer to shorten or extend the duration. And you'll notice that the blue handles, which contain the in and out animation, they actually stay the same. So you can move this and change the duration, and the in and out animations remain the same. So once you have it at the correct duration, now it's time to track the motion. Move the playhead to the beginning of the comp, then select the video clip layer go to the tracker panel and here press track motion, and then you can zoom in on the comp just like we did in the previous effect, move the tracker point to an area of the object with high contrast. So once that's done, hit edit target, make sure that you have selected the box callout layer, and then hit play until it finishes the duration of the composition. Then you can hit apply. And now when we play it back, you can see that the callout is moving with the car, but we need to make some adjustments to the position of the target and the content in the boxes. So this is where you can open up the box callout layer and open up master properties that come with this template. So here we can start with the point's position, and you can adjust the target and content parameters. The content parameters will move the text box and the line together. And then we can zoom in just a little bit more to make it easier. Press H to use the hand tool to move the frame into position view, and then press V to go back to the selection tool. And this is where you can then go in and adjust the target into place. So once in place, let's zoom back out to see how it looks. I think it's looking pretty good, but what we can do next is go down to number 2 here, the text block settings. And in this case, I'm going to move the text over some more. And once I do that, I'm actually going to go back to the point position content parameter and move the content position over some more so it's better fitting to the scene. Of course, this is going to vary depending on what you're working with. And under number 3 here, you can adjust the dot and line settings. For example, if you didn't want a dot and a circle, you can just open these up and press the on button to turn them off. And now you can see that they're off. And instead, let's say you want to add a plus sign. You can turn on the plus just like this. So you can play around with these parameters until the callout is in the best style and location for your scene. And now that we've adjusted everything, when we play it back, you can see that it animates out in the correct place and it's tracking the motion of the car. So now let's do the exact same thing, but with the second callout. Let's drag this composition into our current comp and let's move and resize the duration of it for our scene. And now we need to make another tracker. So again, hit track motion, and this time I'll move the track point to the front of the car, and then I'll edit the target to be the callout 01, and then hit play to track, and once it's done, hit apply. And then you can adjust the callout master properties just like we did before, so that way the target and the content and the lines all match up to the way you want the composition to look. In this case, I'm going to turn off the dot and just move the target so the line looks like it's just emerging from the front of the car. And if this is your first time using this template and you want to edit the content of the text, just go up to the callout folder and go to the all folder. And from within this, just open up the text blocks comp. And from within this composition, you can just click and edit the content of the text however you want. And so that is our final effect. You can see these really cool tracked callouts animating out of a moving object. And now on to replacing and tracking a screen. So here I have this stock video clip. You can see also that there are tracking points on the green screen to make the tracking easier. So you'll find lots of different shots like this. If you go to any stock video site, you'll find green screen shots that have tracking points on it. First, let's drag and drop the screen replacement into the composition. It's just this animated retro car that will be in the screen. Next, with the gamer stock video clip selected, move the playhead to the beginning of the comp, and then let's go to the tracker panel. And here, again, select track motion. But from the track type dropdown, choose perspective corner pin. And here, we're going to move each of these trackers to one of the corner tracker points on this monitor. So once that's done, hit edit target and be sure to select the screen replacement video as your target. Then hit play. So once it's done tracking, then hit apply. Now you can see that the screen replacement video has nicely morphed to exactly the perspective of the screen. But of course, it's not scaled up yet, but we will do that in a second. But first, we need to chroma key. So first, let's move the replacement video beneath the gamer video clip layer. Then go to effects and search for Keylight and double click to apply it to the gamer stock video clip. Then from effect controls, use the screen color dropper to select the green from the monitor. So you can see that there's some transparency happening here. To fix this, go to view and from the dropdown, select screen matte. And so from here, you want the white to be completely white. You don't want any gray happening here. And in the black, you also do not want any gray because gray means transparency. So what we need to do to get rid of the gray is toggle open the screen matte, and from clip white, let's click and scrub to the left to lower this value down until all of the gray disappears. And then from the monitor here, let's increase the black clipping to remove some of the gray around the corners. So now it's perfectly white and black, except of course we have the tracker still here, but just ignore those for now. And now select the retro screen replacement layer. And here we can press S on our keyboard to bring up scale. And then you can move these parameters to scale it up so that way it fills the entire monitor. So now as we play it back, it's basically done. We just need to remove the black tracking points. So to do that, we need to create some subtracting mask on this stock video clip. So just select this stock gamer layer and then go to the rectangle tool. And here we're going to just click and drag to make the first rectangular mask that will cover up the first tracking point. Then you'll see that a mask was created in the comp. And from the type dropdown here, we need to change it from add to subtract. And now the tracking point is completely gone, but as we scrub through, the camera moves. So we need to animate the mask path. So here next to mask path, you're going to hit the stopwatch. And then you're going to scrub the playhead forward until you start to see the tracking point peek out again from behind the mask. And then you just need to click on the mask and move it back so it's covered over the target. So you'll see after you do this that a keyframe was made. So then just repeat this for every tracking point, and you're going to create a new mask for each corner and then animate the mask path until it's done. And for the center tracking points here, you don't need to make an individual mask for each point. You can just make one big mask to get rid of them, and you don't even need to keyframe it because the movement is so subtle. And so that's how you can replace the screen using the Keylight tool, as well as some masking to get rid of the tracking points. And now we have our final tracked screen replacement. And finally, a bonus tip, using Dynamic Link, you can actually drag in this After Effects comp directly into your Premiere Pro project panel. So that way, if you ever make changes in After Effects again, the composition is automatically updated. And that's the bonus tip. So that's all for this video. If you have any other motion tracking effects that you want me to cover in a future video, just leave a comment below and I'll check it out. And also don't forget that you can get 70% off your first month of Element. So that means $9 for unlimited everything. I know, May, it's a great deal. So go check it out in my description box below and I'll see you guys next time. Bye. What are your thoughts on your first week with Premiere Gal? Pretty good?